Well, today was Tanzania's new President John Magufuli's first day on the job. The citizens, and particularly the youth of the East African nations, are watching to see how quickly he will embark on fulfilling his campaign promises. During my recent visit to Tanzania, I spoke with a number of young Tanzanians to find out what they want the next government to do and what they see as their role. Today, I introduce Ismail Ramadhan Biro.
I'm a common citizen. Currently, I'm working with the Tanzania Bora Initiative. We have this program called Uchaguzi 2015 Tanzania. It's actually a program that was designed to promote the engagement of the young people in civic matters. Yeah.
Now, you know, this election has brought a lot of issues to the surface, particularly in terms of the development of Tanzania. As a youth of this country, where do you think Tanzania is in comparison to the other countries in the region?
What I like most about this country is that we have young people who have woken up, and they're more interested to engage in issues that matters to this country, including getting them civically engaged, and sometimes even go to vote to elect the leaders that they believe will carry forward this country.
Mm-hmm. Now, you are considered to be the people who will determine the change that will bring the future that you like. What is it that you want to see happen in Tanzania, especially after the election?
I want to see youth are more engaged in economic activities, because, you know, we have a very good workforce, but at the same time, youth are the ones who are suffering the most. They're unemployed. The quality of education that they're receiving does not preparing them well to encounter different challenges that they face after they come out of schools. So we are looking forward to a country that provides a very friendly environment for youth to excel, but at the same time to participate and be part of the decisions that are being made by the government or stakeholders who are involved in the development arena.
What are some of the challenges that you think particularly the youth face in this country?
I think it's about time that the government tries to see as to how it can help the youth from different regions to sit together, to have that clear body that will help them to sit down, present issues, at the same time being able to now to take the deliberations up there for the implementations.